I always enjoy meeting new friends at Halloween, and this is some of the creatures at the Netherworld Haunted House. Hey guys, do you mind if I take a look inside?
I'll take that as a yes.
Oh! Oh!
New friend.
I'm here with Ben Armstrong, one of the owners of Netherworld. Ben, this place is massive. It's got to be a year-round operation.
Oh, yes. We work on this thing absolutely all year long. We conceptualize it. We work on all the creatures, and then we begin construction as early as February. But what we're going to do now, though, we're going to make you into one of the creatures. We're going to transform you into a monster that even your mother would be proud of.
I feel pretty. I feel pretty.
Okay, I'm all zombied up. I'm teaming up with the Nightmare King. We're gonna go scare some kids. Come on.
So this is our spot right here, Nightmare King?
Yes, this is it, my friend.
All right, what's the call? What's the game plan?
We start here. You use the fall to your advantage. Just come up to the fall. With the illusion, you're rising. You're a dead man rising from the grave.
Yes, I love
zombie,
it.
Yes.
I just had my first scream. Tasted good.
Every night they line up around the block at haunted houses like these across America, bringing an estimated $300 million a year.
The haunted house industry has changed dramatically in the last 15 to 20 years. So you really need to deck it all out in 360. Everything's got to be good. And the technology is increasing. We have, like I said, a lot of animatronic, sophisticated characters that move. We use a lot of projections. We use a lot of illusions. So we're constantly upping the ante to give the customer more than just a guy jumping out. Scare them. Although that is the core of what we do.
Whew, talk about sensory overload. Working on haunted houses is an adrenaline rush. Now it's time to get back to my day job. Zombie Rob Marciano, Norcross, Georgia.